There is a lot of hype regarding treatment of cancer with personalized medicine, targeted therapy, and also a new word called as precision medicine. So I am here to basically explain to you about what these terminologies mean in the treatment of cancer and how medical oncologists like me utilize these strategies for cancer management today. So basically, as we all are aware, all the cells of our body, even though they contain the same genes, behave in different ways. In the same way, since they behave in different ways, they basically carry different identities on the surface. So these identities of a cell are basically called as receptors. Receptors are a way by which these cells communicate with each other. Cells of different kinds communicate with each other. Cells of the same kind communicate with each other. And thereby, the normal processes of our body occur. So, when a normal cell becomes a cancer cell, there are going to be certain changes not only in the genes of the cancer cell, but also on the surface of the cancer cell. What happens with this change is that the cancer cell is basically provided with properties by which it can do something that only a cancer cell can do and not the normal cell can do, such as invade the nearby tissues, produce certain harmful chemicals, and at the same time spread from one place to another. It would be hard to imagine a normal lung cell to spread to your stomach. But a cancer cell can spread from a lung to probably the liver. So precision medicine, targeted therapy, and personalized medicine basically are very similar to each other, in which you are utilizing certain signature receptors on the surface of cancer cell to kill the cancer cells. So you develop certain medicines in the lab by which these medicines will sit mostly on the receptors that are expressed by the cancer cell. So a preferential kill is provided by these targeted therapies, whereby the normal cells can be spared of the side effects. As you would be aware, chemotherapy has that limitation wherein preferentially the cancer cells are affected by the chemotherapy, but even the normal cells can also have temporary damages which definitely can heal by themselves. Now, when you use these targeted therapies, what happens is that these medicines sit on the surface of the cancer cell, and when there is an interaction between this, there would be basically a set of processes that would start inside a cancer cell, and the cancer cell would be destroyed by the physiological process. Another way is the same targeted therapy medicine will sit on the surface of the cancer cell, and because of this interaction, there would be basically a recruitment of all the normal body immune cells or immunity cells, which will then act against the cancer cell and destroy again in a physiological way. Now, that is the major way of using targeted therapy. Another way of targeted therapy, which we have been using since several decades, is also hormonal therapy. Hormonal therapy is no different. Hormonal therapy is the use of certain medicines which block the hormonal stimulation of the cancer cells. An example would be breast cancer or prostate cancer. Many of breast cancer cells can be basically stimulated by the hormones. So you use certain medicines by which the availability of hormones in the body is reduced, thereby the breast cancer cells are not stimulated, or the interaction of the hormones with the breast cancer cell is avoided. So that is a very common example that I would give for targeted therapy. There are several different mechanisms of targeted therapy that are being evolved. Cancer medicine or the branch of medical oncology which deals with certain medicines to deal with cancer is probably the fastest growing branch of medicine, wherein lot of research at a rapid pace is occurring, by which we are basically having newer and advanced cancer medicines that are being brought into the mainstream for treatment of cancer patients, and amazing responses are seen. Is targeted therapy used only in advanced cancer? Not really. Today we are using targeted therapies even for early stages, so that the cure rates are increased significantly. Can it be used in advanced stages? Yes. The advanced stages of the past, which could not be controlled at all, are being controlled today with today's cancer therapy, so that we can give long-term control to our patients. There are patients living almost close to a decade and beyond with today's targeted therapies. Hence, I would believe that immunotherapy and targeted therapy are heralding a new era in the treatment of cancer, where we are slowly but steadily moving away from chemotherapy as the only way of controlling cancer.